we have already used many methods. The methods have already taken us far from the source. That is why you are asking this question, that what method is now needed to come to the source. The same thing that took you away from the source will not bring you back to the source. By you were told that you are incomplete, so you need education to become respectable and lovable. That was a method. Now knowledge is not just knowledge. Knowledge is wonderful and beautiful if it is just knowledge. But when knowledge becomes a means for inner fulfillment, then knowledge is a disease. It's a method. It's a method. If knowledge were just to earn your bread, then knowledge is all right. But when knowledge is there to earn your identity, then knowledge is poisonous. Do you understand the difference between these two? Mankind does need knowledge. Knowledge is needed so that you can have all this. It's all right. Some of it is good. It facilitates. So in that sense, knowledge is all right. But when knowledge becomes your backbone, how do I express it? When knowledge becomes your foundation, your essence, then there is a very deep problem. Do not ask for method. Methods, whatever we have been doing so far, is a method. All methods have only given us more despondency. Now just see that methods will not work. That you do not need a method to get to the source. That it is all right. Just relax. That's all. Just that's all.
That's where I found Ashtavakra most relevant. He says, you know, you are not a Brahmana, you don't belong to any caste, any ashrama, you are pure consciousness. Be happy.
Be happy.
You see, the ultimate thing is that as long as you. It's amazing clarity in all his explanations.
You see how you are mentioning him again and again. That is the call of truth. That is your temple. See how you have mentioned him not less than 4 times already.
No, because I read 50 years and suddenly this brought a lot of peace. You know, because every time you were subjected to something, some past thinking, but here he said Sufi totally.
And Ashtavakra will not tell you that this or that is important.
No, he is nothing.
He will not say that go and worship and this and that.
Not even this is. Why do you need to go to Samadhi?
Why do you need even Vivek? What is Samadhi? What is Turiya? He is saying everything is false. Because whatever has been captured as a word is now just a word. The real will not be expressed through the word Samadhi. When there is real Samadhi, you will not even call it Samadhi. So that is why he is saying, why do you need Samadhi?
Beautiful. Samadhi is also a saint lying in a, when he is buried, that's also Samadhi. So.
All that the wise ones, our friends, have ever told us is this. It's perfect. As it is. Chill out. Smile, laugh, dance.
We are taught, jo hai, jaisa hai, theek hai.
And that also means that if you feel like changing something, even that is alright. When it is said that what is alright, that does not mean that the status quo has to be maintained. It also means that you have all the right to change everything and that right is alright. If it remains as it is, lovely. If it wants to change, even more lovely. If the wind blows, wow, it's singing. If the wind doesn't blow, wow, it's so silent.
But there's risk in change.
There's
always risk in change.
I mean,
it's not necessary that all the time change is for the better.
It's not a question of better or worse, because whenever you say better or worse, you have your own benchmarks of right and wrong and morality and thought and the rest of it. So the saints never talk in the language of right, wrong, better, worse. They only talk about the true and the false. What is and what is not.